Welcome back to HTC Recharge Day 2. We are at the semifinal stage, and we are about to see Trump go at it versus Dog. These players have made it pretty far. They've had to win against two opponents so far, and the field has been pretty tough. And I'd actually say that the lineup in the end here has been a pretty impressive one. Dog, Trump, Gara, and...
Checking the name of our fourth player.
Checking the name.
I can't save you.
It's Nuguri, I think, but I don't want to like pronounce it wrong. So.
Nuguri, yes.
Nuguri, okay.
Nuguri from
okay.
Korea.
Okay, Nuguri from Korea. There we go.
I certainly agree with you. The lineup is pretty good. Trump and Dog, like two great players, top of the world, and especially like if Trump wins today's tournament, he might be. I don't think maybe in the top 10. Top 20 of the world ranking, and Dog is already there with an amazing score. So,
Gara is very close as well.
Yeah, I'm definitely looking forward to that. Gara, I think he's top 10 as well. So, as you said, an impressive lineup. Nuguri, actually, a player who was unranked before. I think he maybe had one registered match. With this tournament, he's definitely making a splash on the rankings. Yeah, but. Trump and Dog, man. I'm excited. Trump won versus Life Coach. He won versus Bunny Muffins. And he is getting closer to the goal to becoming the champion. And that will be his first title.
Mm-hmm.
Did Dog win anything before? I think Dog came close a couple
he's
of
like
times.
The ultimate second placer.
Yeah, he's the final boss.
Final boss. Mm-mm. All right, well, the players are about ready. Dog's lineup again is Warlock, Priest, Druid, and Trump has Warlock, Hunter, Shaman. So a little bit of flavor. A lot of the players are bringing the top three powerhouses, the Warrior, Warlock, Hunter. Most of those have been knocked out. I think almost half the players have that lineup. And right now, I believe it's just Nuguri, isn't it?
Yeah, it is just Nuguri with the strongest lineup. But it will be so interesting to see Trump win here because he's bringing that Mech Shaman, and that was the deck that carried Forsen at the last tournament. Forsen took it with Mech Shaman as one of his top decks.
Yeah, and of course our returning champion Forsen, I believe, was knocked out by Nuguri.
Yeah,
wasn't he?
Yeah. Yeah, because he didn't bring the Mech Shaman.
Uh-oh. No Mech Shaman, boys.
Didn't work.
All right, guys, our players have queued in. Dog will be playing Priest, and Trump will be playing Warlock. Trump right now is playing Dragon Warlock, and Dog is playing a draw-heavy type of Priest, a lot of answers. It is going to be a pretty back-and-forth type of game. We had this matchup earlier, didn't we?
Yeah, I believe we had. We discussed which deck is better because it didn't seem that obvious while discussing it, but when we went into the deck discussion, actually... appears that Malygos Warlock might have a slight edge because it is like Handlock a bit, but in the end, Dog was the one who won the match because he stole Malygos Mortal Coil.
He was playing the Malygos Warlock as well. Yeah.
So that was pretty impressive. Let's see if he can do it the second time.
Okay, well, we'll see. We got Zombie Chow opener from Dog. Dog is playing a fairly anti-aggro Priest. The Death Lord is a very interesting card. As we talked about recently, that it's not very good on its own, but because a lot of decks these days are playing creature-based combos, it turns to work out pretty damn well.
Yeah, it's a very interesting card. Like, I've played it recently in a Druid deck, Chromagus Druid, and one time I lost because the player got the Grommash and then he enraged it and then killed me. But other than that, you get minions that you can actually deal with them, especially if you have the abilities like a Light Bomb.
Mm-hmm. All right, well, here you can clear this, and it might be worth it. The best clear that I see is Coin, and then Soulfire on Deathlord, and then play a Hellfire. I think most of those cards are disposable at this stage. They all basically do the same thing, and you have to use some of them.
I'm not really sure. Like, this is definitely a clear, but I think I would favor Implosion, even though it might play into the Holy Nova.
Mm-hmm.
Players in those new priests, they drop Holy Nova, and you want to get some Implosion value there.
Okay, unfortunately, Healbot is out, and in is a big game.
This is not the best minion you can get.
No. Now, with board control and two Hellfires, it kind of sucks. The discard wasn't really the best.
Trump really committed with that play. With double Hellfire, it seems, as you said, a bit awkward. So it might give Dog a chance to actually... Well, with simple Shadow Madness, he can kill the 4-2 and get an Imp.
Hmm. Yeah. There's nothing even close to as strong as in anything else as Shadow Madness.
Alright, so for Trump right now, the plan will be draw. Draw as much as possible, even though you might want to play Corruptor because it's body on board, but I think you will not win the game if you just play card every turn. You need to get your combo pieces.
Yeah, right now it's looking pretty good for the Priest already. The Priest has a lot of answers. I'll probably see the board opened up here with Sylvanas. Sylvanas was a really big problem for his last Dragonlock victim. And we might see a repeat of that. No, instead he goes with Ascension.
He might want to keep Sylvanas when there is actually something on board that he can steal. But I would not hate Sylvanas as well. This deck is running a lot of those value creatures like Twilight Drakes. And with no minions on board, it will be hard to kill Sylvanas with something like Implosion. And you've seen one Implosion being discarded by Soulfire already. Alright, so just a Twilight Drake, and that's it. From the dog's perspective, he is one mana short of stealing that Twilight Drake. I have
no time for games. The Shrinkmeister ball play.
Yeah.
But this Sylvanas kind of stops much from happening. Okay.
So, oh man, double Hellfire? Is there anything?
I think you actually tap and set up for a double Hellfire next turn. Right?
If you tap, will you have to pass? Like, because you can double Hellfire this turn, and you will be able to clear the board fully. If you coin, but at this point, you might actually be setting up double Hellfire next turn. The good part is, like, Sylvanas is not going to just die attacking into one of this into the Twilight Drake. There needs to be something else.
Mm-hmm.
But now he can just steal the Twilight and kill the 2/1, and I think that's
that's as Hellfiery as it gets. And it would be so good if he. If Trump top decks a dragon, because he'll be able to Hellfire and coin out a Blackwing Corruptor to clear the board.
Well, from Doc's perspective, if you Shrinkmeister the 4/5 and then you steal with Cabal and kill the 2/1, you're in a good spot. Like, you have a double 4/5, you have a 3/2, you have a 5/3 Sylvanas, and basically one Hellfire doesn't do much. You still are left with some good minions. But from Trump's perspective, that would be amazing, because with double Hellfire, he just clears and deals 6 damage to face.
Mm-hmm. Well, he cleared the double Hellfire, but if he gets a dragon, it's like way better. And he did get a dragon. So now the 2/1 can go in Sylvanas. Oh no, he can't clear. Whoops.
Yeah, he can't clear with this.
There's 2 5 health minions. Okay. Yeah, he has to do the double Hellfire.
That's still amazing. By the way, Dog attacked face, which is much better, and Trump will have to take 6 damage himself. There are no Molten Giants in his deck. So even though he cleared the board with a good Thought Steal, no Malagas! That's so awkward, right?
Yeah, right. Alright, well, the Healbot kind of closes that gap. Here comes Malagas, but most of the spells in this deck have been used already.
You might... So I definitely want to play Corruptor into the 3-3. But then I'm thinking maybe Azure Drake first to draw a card and see what I get.
Drawing a card seems a bit dangerous here.
Why is that? Like, if you play Corruptor, like, what else do you do? Do you just heal? Like, I would not expect Priest to kill me from having a 1 minion on board.
Well, what if you play the Azure Drake first to see if you get a better option and then coin out the Corruptor?
Yeah, I mean, like, Azure Drake is the play, I think. That's why I would not tap. I would definitely Azure Drake and coin Corruptor.
Oh, I see. Okay. Yeah. Seems fine, but Trump hasn't made it yet, so he might be thinking about something else.
If
he's probably going with a heal here.
If you heal... Oh, he's going for Azure Drake anyway, okay. Like, if you heal, it means that you really respect Thought Steal. You've seen one card, but the second card, if it's Soulfire, then 5 damage from this, then no, I don't think Priest can kill you at this point. Like, not in one turn.
Well, if that implosion was a Soulfire, yeah, it could. Alright. Very good clear with Life Bomb. Dog heals, draws cards, draws some more nice ones. Lotheb often just give you another full turn.
Do you Maligos and coil the zombie?
That's I actually like that.
Yeah. I think at this point, like, just staring at 4 cards, you can go for it. And other plays are just weak minions that don't do much. That is risky, because if there is any way to deal with Maligos, like a Silence or another Shrinkmeister Cabal combo, you just lose the game.
Yeah, but I think you can afford to take these type of risks now.
I agree. Trump going for the safe play, which is also good. It's just a different approach.
Yeah, but I think now we're going to see Lotheb and Deathlord, and that is a pretty big push here.
Yeah, not much else. Unless you go for Implosion, you've seen double Hellfire already. Maligos deck is mostly running only 2 AoE spells. One Hellfire, one Shadow Flame, or double Hellfire.
You can also clear this board with the Valen's Holy Nova. Seems fine.
I think Implosion trade both minions into the... The 3-3 and Lothab was also the play.
Okay. So he Valens the Zombie Chow and hope that if it gets silenced, Trump loses the heal effect.
Yeah, like a dog is pushing for damage. So is there anything that Trump can do? He doesn't have the AoE anymore. He might have still one Shadow Flame in the deck, but I doubt it.
Mm-hmm.
Champ visibly distressed after the play.
Holy Nova grants a card. There's a Light Bomb. Light Bomb's not particularly useful, but Trump still has quite a way to go here. Whoa, that's a big one. There's a huge draw.
So he will be able to coil this. I think you still go with a Belcher, though.
What? No, you BGH the Lotheb.
Oh yeah, that's pretty good. And then you Belcher anyway, right?
Oh, you can Mortal Coil down the Deathlord if you want. If you play the Belcher, you're kind of saying that the Belcher kind of needs the stick. I guess the Belcher and the Mortal Coil are both about the same. I think I prefer the Mortal Coil, but I think this is a complex analysis of what minions are left in the deck.
Well, there's still a lot of small minions, I feel. Should be another Healbot, maybe Farseer. You have the Twilight Drake, which will be a 4-1.
Yeah, you're kind of right. The more you're saying, I think the more I like the Belcher play.
I think you can still attack into it.
But... No, with Belcher, he loses the game to Shadow Madness, though. It's exactly 9. Okay, he draws the Healbot again, and in comes the Argus. Okay, well, Trump can actually win this game at this point.
Yeah, Healbot and Belcher will be huge next turn, and he still has Maligos on board that's uncontested. Or is it? He can kill it with the Light Bomb. and sort of clear, leaving only Defender of Argus.
Well, he can kill Defender of Argus after healing his Northshire. Oh no, it's the last remaining one.
Yeah, never mind. He needs to kill Malagus. Double okay. Death.
Double death.
Trump officially stabilizes.
Finally.
After all those turns. And now Dog needs to draw something good. There is a Fossil, actually. Oh, man.
Double Dragon.
Those are some decent minions.
They are. Okay, he goes with the Harrison. Just to try to contest the Belcher a little bit better.
Well, Trump, at least for...
I mean, Trump doesn't have too many cards left here.
Yeah, he doesn't. Deck is also running thin. But for the Dog, the prospect of just rushing Trump is gone. Now he's back to good old minion trading. And Trump does have that implosion. So many possibilities. Okay, so getting a 4.
Wow. Yeah, Dog realizes it's really bad news. He's already played a Holy Nova and 2 Light Bombs. And like, if you're running 2 Light Bombs and 1 Holy Nova, do you really put in the second one?
You might have a Pyromancer.
Mm-hmm.
But he didn't get it yet.
Well, this is basically like the final stand here. I think if you're Trump, you kind of... Like, you want to get rid of these, but at the same time, you have only, like, a limited number of cards in your deck. If you want to get rid of these, you probably suicide that, the 3-3, or... Oh, no, you have a dragon now. Oh.
Yeah, you have the Raptor. Okay. That's why you want to build that.
So you really only lose 2-1-1s here. You can silence the Twilight Drake. Very, very efficient, in fact.
That was an amazing turn, Trump. I think, like, Dog just wants to see maybe 1-2 cards, and then it's concede. It's not like he can... He's dead next turn, right? 6 plus 4, 10, 15. Well, he
11
can heal.
Plus 4, no. No, he's not quite dead. He has the other Holy Nova. It's just like, is it really that useful right now?
Oh, at least that can kill a couple of minions.
Mm-hmm.
He goes for the draws. What is he looking for?
I think he just needs a higher value Holy Nova. Like, I think he's mostly just trying to stall.
Okay, so at this point for Trump, I don't know how many cards he has in the deck because he doesn't really want to life tap, so he might be respecting the fatigue damage.
Well, we had the warning. The warning, I think, is at 1 or 2 cards.
1, I think, yeah. It's like, so this will be the last card. So definitely...
It looks slightly thicker than 1 card, so I think it might be 2.
Interesting. You might want to go face, actually. But on the other hand, you want to get the value of the from those small minions. Is this the last card? Yep. Well, first time is your last card is not good. But yeah, it is a minion.
It's a minion that dies to death, so no, it's not really anything. It feels like Dog might just win the fatigue game.
That poor Twilight Drake, exactly at 2 points of health. Well, looking at this, it definitely looks possible.
No, it looks certain. I think Trump cannot win this game. I think Dog has won.
Oh man, the back and forth.
Yeah, Trump just drew too many cards. I mean, it looks good from his side, but this death is, it is the well-played.
Yeah, just death, you play the Dark Cultist, and that's it. You can never die after that.
No, you cannot lose. If players disconnect, Dog wins. Actually, if Dog disconnects, I think he might still win. 2, 3, 4, 5, yeah.
So a second kill on the Malagus deck with the priest. Like, that priest actually works for him really well.
Yeah, that is like a really, really anti-aggro priest with double Light Bomb, double Holy Nova, a lot of one drops, and the Death Lords. and to see it really tackle on these control decks at the same time, I think we really underestimated this priest deck.
Yeah, that's for sure. But on the other hand, Trump didn't have the good draw that Malagos needs. Just want to have those combo parts, Tauris, and then burst your opponent. You can even OTK them. This never happened.
Well, you want to start with good minions. He didn't have that. He started with all spells. He had to burn the spells on controlling the board. Emperor Tharson was his last card. So, yeah. I mean, that is the risk that you run when you play combo decks at the same time. I remember very early on, some of the earlier combo decks were the Ravenholt Windspeaker Shaman. And sometimes double Windspeaker were just at the bottom of the deck and you literally could not win a single game. So, yeah.
Or Alexstrasza OTK with Groho, Alexstrasza being your last card.
Yeah, but the thing is with Warrior, you often could just wait that long.
Yeah, just draw Alexstrasza and then win. That's true. It seems like Trump is not taking the Warlock this time. He killed the Shaman versus the Druid.
Mm-hmm. The Druid is double combo Druid, but he's also running a lot of taunts. The thing is, we saw double Earthshock from Trump earlier, so the double Earthshock is a really good punish for some of these taunts, and it may not actually matter. I think, in general, the classic double combo Druid versus the classic Mech Shaman is heavily Shaman-favored, as Druid has nothing to remove cards like Fel Reaver.
Yeah, I agree. Maybe a BGH, but then this deck is so fast, packing up damage and then just finishing it off with Burn. Even before Druid has a chance to heal with Lore. And if you're forced to play Ancient of Lore just to heal, you might be losing at that point. The opening for Trump.
Well, there's a BGH in Dog's hand, which kind of gives him some insurance. Okay. Go with the Mech Warper. Let's see if you have removal. If Trump gets an Annoyatron or a Taunt Totem, it's going to be quite good, though. Oh, that Fel Reaver. That's going to be a liability.
Unless Dog is forced to play a Tempo BGH on 3, because he doesn't have a turn 4 play for now.
Interesting.
Oh, there's a Savager. Then you definitely Savager kill the 3-2 and then attack the 2-3 with your 3-3.
Okay. Wow.
Then we will not see the Fel Reaver on 4. Totem time.
Totem time, boys. I think you actually play the totem here. Yeah. And this is a pretty big signal that Doom is coming. So I'd be really surprised if Dog plays the BGH here.
He got a Wrath, so I think with Wrath he can just kill the Flame Tongue and then shapeshift.
Yeah. Alright. And basically, clear stuff.
If you have stuff to play, you will never play Temple BGH against this deck. Because you are aware that Fel Reaver is a thing.
It's the win condition, yeah. It's the thing. Alright, Fel Reaver. Dog's gonna be pretty happy here.
Yeah, definitely hope that there's no BGH.
And there is.
Hydrove. Wow, that's also a nice card. He will be able to play a 7 drop next turn.
As well as milling 3 extra cards from Trump's deck. And as well as seeing some of them, those are some bad cards for Trump to lose.
Fire Elemental, though, is also a good tempo swing. Dealing with that BGH, setting up a 6-5.
Yeah, Trump is still doing okay on the board, but... That is such a ridiculous card.
Yeah, Trump is super...
Suddenly Trump is winning. Look at... Trump is smiling! What?
Yeah,
what?
He was. He was actually grinning there.
Oh my god. Even Dog realizes how insane that was. Yeah, now Trump's winning by a lot, as he's able to push for so much damage. Wait, oh my god, is that it?
That's the 12 plus 5, 17.
That's lethal.
That's, 21. That's actually even more, because there is a spell damage totem, so it's 6 damage from Lava Burst.
Yep.
Oh my god.
Skill game, boys.
Massive.
I want to see dogs like, are you kidding me?
Yeah. It happens sometimes.
This is basically like the perfect example. You know, Hearthstone's a great game to watch, but you will not want to be the player in dog's seat right now. You don't want to be the player that it's like, you know, everything's going your way. You literally get every single answer, and then you get absolutely slam dunked by triple top deck.
I think it's even more painful for Dog Rip because you just won the game versus Maligus Warlock. You really grinded it out till fatigue. You basically were like sweating to win the game, and then it's like, oh, I guess 1-1.
Yeah. Man, that was pretty insane.
Turn eight.
Yeah, it was turn 8. Lava Burst, Doomhammer, 8 mana. So they're heading into their next game here. They are tied up at 1-1 in our semifinal match. In our first semifinal match, we have another one right after this. The players queued in Dog trying Druid once again, and Trump is trying Warlock once again. Now, this seems heavily Druid favored, does it not?
Well, it depends how you view Druid versus Handlock, because I think it's not that favored. I would probably favor Druid a bit. But it will really depend how much synergy Trump can get with Twilight Drake, Corruptor. It might be closer to 50-50, actually. It's all about minion trading. Can Druid get the White Growth? And actually, Dog missed that.
Do you think there's any chance Dog has cut Keeper of the Grove? Because he has a lot of cards you don't expect in here, and I haven't seen a Keeper at all from his deck.
It's too flexible. No chance at all. Definitely
no chance.
I haven't
seen a single one.
I haven't, but I haven't seen a single Druid list without them.
I know the current Mill Druid only runs one.
Oh my god, that's a mistake for sure. You should add one, plus one.
Plus one, you think? All right.
Lotha pretty strong on turn three. By the way, Trump's hand is pretty good. There is a nice curve. There is Twilight Dragon 4. Actually, this is tricky. Like, he needs another dragon. Because if he plays Twilight Dragon 4, he will not be able to play Corruptor. Unless he actually coins Corruptor on 4 to deal that damage. And
that's looking better and better now. But there might be a better combination with spells here.
So with Corruptor, you can kill... Oh, man. It's just going to die to the BGH.
No, why don't you just kill the BGH with the Corruptor?
Yeah, but then Corruptor dies to Lothab.
That's fine. That's 2-for-1. Take back tempo in the game. And there is that Keeper there. Damn.
Yep.
They're not gone.
And it's golden. Pretty good Keeper. I look at the Implosion. Is there any way to have a great Implosion here and maybe kill everything? Like, actually, if you hit 4... you will kill everything, but that's
optimistic. Random. Yeah.
You might want to have Twilight Drake after all. Because the problem with Corruptor is you kill it, you have Imp Gang Boss, but then Lothab just trades with it, and you want to have board advantage there. So, and with this, you can also coin out Tauris on next turn.
You also are not too punished by Keeper of the Grove. That's something a lot of players pay attention to in Arena because, you know, these are cards that you play in like every deck, like Silences and Drakes and stuff. But the idea is if you're going to have your Drake silenced, you want to do it before your opponent has 6 mana because then it would die to the common 4 mana silence. It's called Spellbreaker. Some of you guys might not know about that card. Hero power. Yeah, you've seen it? Wow, that's amazing. It must be a rare sight.
It was a rare sight. Right now, like, I don't even remember its face.
Mm-hmm.
So for Trump here, you might think Implosion. I would definitely love to attack into the Lothab with my Twilight Drake and then Coil.
Yeah, the Emperor seems so good, but it's It's kind of like not getting value off that Drake that really sucks here if you do make that play.
Implosion is some damage, but then you might be thinking about swipe and you don't want to have a really swipeable board. Coil makes sense. You can still play Corruptor if you draw into Dragon.
Healbot. Okay. Yeah, I mean, combo is a real threat as these turns go by.
Yeah, we are getting closer and closer to the combo. This deck runs one Defender of Argus, I believe.
Yeah, we saw it come out of the Deathlord in the game earlier.
Now Torison is much better, but I don't think this is the Torison turn. I feel like it's a good Hellfire Coil.
No, it's a Corruptor turn. You want to develop this board. You're not threatened against combo yet. You kind of want to save Hellfire against those Shades, right?
Not really. I don't think Shades are that threatening, actually. If you play Corruptor, can you clear this without using Nurgle?
No, we just kill the Lothab. That's pretty good.
All right, so I guess you can deal with that. I just wanted to coil because drawing is nice, and you want to increase the Emperor value, even though you already have Maligus and Dark Bomb. So Emperor will be good anyway. But if you get a Soulfire maybe and hit three combo pieces, that would be much better. Mm-hmm.
Okay. You have the combo, but you're just under that pressure. This is kind of the situation that I expected the game to turn into, where you know, even though you might have some really nice cards, it's hard to really play them all out.
Yeah, not enough mana, and there was not enough time to play the Torison. I think Implosion was the best choice. I would Implosion as well.
And okay, then. Well, you're dead to combo anyway. With Darson in hand, you might as well tap.
That's true. But it's still turn 8, so...
There's turn 9. Oh man, there's another Savage Roar.
There's a Healbot, so maybe Chumble will be able to escape. But he needs to clear. And Healbot. Or like Belcher.
Well, you have Dark Bomb and Abuser that you can play alongside the Healbot, so this seems possible, is it? No, you're one mana off clearing, so...
Maybe you can just leave the Keeper of the Grove on board. You're not dead to combo if Keeper is just there, so just kill the 5-5, probably with Abusive, set up the Belcher. I mean, you're not dead if the Belcher is there, so Belcher, Abusive... And trade everything into the 5-5.
Yeah.
You pass. If you tap, are you dead? Not really. So you might actually.
He goes for the Dark Bomb. Okay. He wants to push for some damage. He's just choosing not to play around swipe at all, which is going to turn out all right for him. With Innervate draw, oh my god.
Well, he has double force, so it's not like you can innervate double force in Savage Roar, but still, that's lots of damage. And he will be able to force and Keeper this turn if he chooses to.
He was able to Keeper and charge Drew of the Claw, I think was a good hit there.
Yeah.
Gets a swipe. This really kind of secures the win. This is like just... denying so many options that Trump might need.
Well, yeah, Trump has to clear and heal at the same time.
Yeah, I don't see that happening.
I don't see it as well. As well, okay, so he can Corruptor Implosion. No, he won't be able to. Oh man, if he keeps the taunt alive, but I don't see that happening as well.
I think he's just gonna do Implosion, Healbot. Wow! these like YOLO 4 implosions are actually working.
Yeah, and this can save him.
It can save him, but he's just not winning yet, and the druid has so many good turns ahead.
Yeah, for Doc, he just deals some damage again, develops a board, maybe kills stuff.
Well, it's 18. You can get your opponent to 3 life. 3 life is pretty low. You have the keeper for 2 direct on the following turn. You have to come up with 1 damage. The thing is, you might have to come up with 1 damage through taunts, so that might be hard to do, but then you could always do Force of Nature and then Silence of Taunt. That might work.
Yeah, you basically don't expect that much taunts. Like, there's really one Defender of Argus in this deck, and you've seen it. You've seen one Belcher. Most of the list run only one Belcher. And you will not expect to die because you haven't seen Thorison, so there's no possibility of Maligos with a couple of spells.
Alright, well, Dog is a big fan of this play where you just get your opponent to like exactly 14 while using the fewest possible cards. I guess that's just the way you play this deck.
I think it works, like just putting your opponent in the tough spot where he has to both clear and escape the range.
Well, Trump has to tap here. There's no way to stay alive with the current hand. There's no way to win the game. It has to be a tap.
Did he play double healbot? There was one.
I think he did. I think he played one healbot quite early in the game here.
Alright, so Defender of Argus is a possibility. Unless you actually hope there is no combo, because the situation is so hopeless that you have to assume no combo. And I will try to put myself in a situation where I can maybe win with Maligus.
Yeah. Very optimistic, though. Doesn't quite work out for Trump. Trump is behind once again. Dog gets that second point on the board while Trump still has just his one. Dog's last deck, Warlock. He's not playing Dragon Handlock. You sure it's Handlock?
Yeah, we've seen Giants and Ancient Watchers. I think we've seen Ragnaros from him.
Okay. Well, the Hunter matchup is probably fairly even. What about the Dragon Lock versus the Hand Lock? That's a matchup I'm not familiar with at all.
So it's in heavy favor of the Maligos deck, because in the beginning it's more or less similar, just minion trading. And then both decks go down in life because they life tap, and Maligos will have enough time to accumulate the combo pieces.
Okay. Well, that is what it's going to be. It is Warlock versus Warlock. Trump has to win this to stay alive in the tournament. Dog is basically on match point. The winner of this match advances to our final. All right.
Trump has to win with Hunter as well if Trump wins this.
Yeah, he needs the point to stay alive in the tournament.
Yeah, that's right. Oh, man, then there's the BGH already. Trump is playing only one, right?
No, I think we've seen two. I think we saw one get Deathlord out, and then he drew into the other against the Priest, if I'm not mistaken.
Okay, because two is a staple. Like, you mostly do play double BGH in this deck.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, in Gangbus, that's an okay start. Hellfire is actually not that great. You would like to have Twilight Drakes. You want to have Corruptors. He gets Iron Beak for that Drake as well.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, Hellfire just fails to kill most of the minions in Handlock. I think it's mostly used for the more aggressive decks.
That's true. Well, for now, Trump does well, actually. And as I said, like in this matchup, you'll have enough time to draw into combo pieces. So that would be interesting. It's not unwinnable for Dog, but it will be an uphill battle. Basically, when you drop to 17 points of health, you have to start worrying after Thorison.
We haven't yet seen like a true Maligos combo yet. All of these Dragon Handlocks have been like, or Dragon Locks have been pressured down where they've had to use a lot of the combo pieces, or just they didn't have a Thorison turn. Just like something hasn't worked out for them.
Yeah, actually the best Maligos combo that we've seen was from Dog when he played a Priest.
Yeah, that's true.
Okay, so now you probably tap. You tap as much as possible.
Tap into the ooze. Alright.
Dog, I'm interested how this Torison from Dog, well, not this turn, but overall, how it will change the game. Because Torison is always warping the experience. Business Sergeant is not that great.
Yeah, we'll probably see one of the implosions. I mean, Trump has two, and he doesn't have anything else too great to play.
Well, with Abusive, you can kill the 3-5 with the ooze, and then...
but if you only had one implosion, like before that, but you have two, you need to make use of this.
Now we can coil.
Mm-hmm. Looks good to me.
Yeah, basically the plan is to keep the board under control, get some damage in, not too much, and draw. Get all the combos.
The Hellfire, followed by the Ooze. Both players sporting the Acidic Swamp Ooze. Oh, that's a nice card. You're on 9, so you can tap to 10 and then kill off the Ooze with the Blackwing Corruptor.
Seems it like is amazing,
very,
yeah.
Very clear play here.
Both players, they do play double Hellfire, right? Yeah.
Well, yeah, both players had double Hellfire in hand. Both players actually had double Dark Bomb in hand.
So now, Trump actually has Maligos and Dark Bomb. He will need the Torison at some point. And for Dog, Dr.
Boom. Bones,
yeah. Boom on 7. It's green. No choice.
Yeah. No choice.
Well, normally you should snap play Boom, right?
Yeah. But I think in tournament formats, you generally just don't snap play anything. You give a lot of information when you, like, play something quickly.
Yeah, sometimes you can use it to your advantage. If you play something quickly, you might give information that you might not have anything else, but you actually, in fact, have it, but you planned your turn perfectly.
Okay.
You can use the tempo of the game to gain advantage. I think, like, one tournament, Ekop was playing super fast, and then he made his opponents nervous, and they actually started playing fast as well, and they made mistakes.
That is very interesting.
Okay, so here, BGH might be an obvious play, but...
I like Hellfire, you're not going to get that much use out of it. You might take a lot of damage, though. Actually, if you Hellfire, you might die.
Those bombs, man.
Yeah, Hellfire and double Dark Bomb from Gog.
I like BGH because you want to put your opponent at around 15. You don't care about Molotovs that much, and you need to start counting damage. Where with Dark Bomb, double Hellfire, Abusive, there's a lot of damage potential. If you pick up a Soulfire, you might actually not even need Maligus to win the game.
Hellfire, boys.
There's an imp being spawned, and it dies.
Yep. That's a good imp. Take some damage. That's a card. 2 life. Yeah, Trump, I think, has mostly just been digging for Emperor Tharsis in this game. Not been too lucky with that card. When he has it, he can't play it. When he needs it.
I mean, you Dark Bomb the BGH, you have Silence Mortal Coil for the Drake, and then you Lothic for 5 mana exactly.
But something was still alive, right? Like, if you play Lothic, what do you do exactly, once again?
You'll have an Owl and a Lothab, and they have no board.
Okay.
Oh, no, he was on 9 mana. He wasn't able to Lothab. Oh, man.
Yeah.
Yep, I suck.
Well, it's a long day, yesterday and today, so it can happen. But there's no lethal for Trump yet, I believe.
Mm-hmm.
And he needs to clear the board if he wants to play Torison. He is at 11 himself. Or maybe actually he has the heal bot as well.
You but think just Doris and the heal bot?
That's 11 mana.
Oh, right. So many possibilities. Man, why is Doris in 5 mana? Buff Emperor, please.
Oh man, he goes for the risk here. So we have 7 damage from Dog. He's not running Soulfires.
No, and he's used both Hellfires and a Dark Bomb already. So that's probably why you do this.
I mean, it's just so unlikely that you're actually running more damage than that. The most you can really anticipate is like double Argus Dark Bomb, right?
Yeah, from Handlock. And most of the Handlock's decks, they do play one Argus as well. One double Sunfear, one Argus.
But I believe Trump also saw Ragnaros. This is the second day, and in the first day, all the players played out all their decks, all the ones that won, because it is Conquest. So this is a little bit of risk against Ragnaros, in fact.
It is, but then there's 1 in 5. Well, we know that it will actually 1 in 4 because of Dark Bomb. Lotheb was a very good choice.
Yeah, that shuts out Trump out of a lot of options. He still has the heal bot though, so he'll probably be fine.
He can play Healbot, Corruptor, and Abuse the Sergeant. So with this, he can almost, well, basically clears Lotheb, clears the 3/5, and 4/8 is left, but he'll
Yeah.
go up to 15.
Yeah, that seems fine. And he'll get another Emperor Tharson tick, which is really, really big.
Now he just needs to pick up a Soulfire.
Even think he needs that.
Well,
What does dog have? Dog has
Shadow
nothing.
Flame. But other than that, he will not be able to win even with the Ragnar's top deck here. All right, so Trump escapes. Puts him down to 12, and Doc will be probably forced to sorry since Shadow Flame this board.
Well, Trump can tap here. Decides not to.
He has lethal with Hellfire and Dark Bomb next turn. That will be 16 points of damage.
Hellfire does 8. Dog will probably Shadow Flame.
Yeah, dog. If dog attacks and then uses a Shadow Flame with something, he's dead. He needs to lifetap.
He needs to dark bomb the face after Shadow Flame because that will result in a tie from the Hellfire.
That's true.
But that is like extremely non-intuitive, so I don't see dog even getting the tie here. I would be so impressed.
Also, Trump has a really good chance to draw into Soulfire. But with this, deal some damage early, and then you need to draw into the reach cards, like Kill Commands. With this hand from Trump, I'm not sure if viewers can actually see it right now. Oh,
Yep.
yeah. All right, perfect. So this hand is actually, with Mad Scientist, it's all right. You have the early curve, you will be able to deal some damage. And you already have double kill command. So if you continue drawing minions that can deal damage, you will have just a sick burst hidden in your hand.
Yeah, often, like in this matchup, this is like one of the classics, basically. I've noticed that generally you have to assume some risk as the Warlock, and usually that risk means you have to not be bothered to play around double kill command.
Yeah, maybe around one, but around double. If you play around double Q command, you gimp yourself too much. You basically play handicap and
Yeah. That's a great draw, by the way. Think you play that and keep smorking.
if he goes face here with everything, that's 6, 7 points of damage, 15 left. And next turn he can double Q command for 10, and he will have enough. So. Well, Dog already facing a situation where he might just die.
I think he is dead.
Wait, if he plays Belcher, is he dead?
Silenced. Yeah.
You're right. And then he doesn't have a heal, so that should be over. Silence kill command and then kill command hero power next turn.
Actually, no, the silence kill command is one off lethal.
Yeah, but then like next turn he'll have kill command hero power, so Dog will have to magically heal, kill the board, and block the hero power.
Yeah, so we just talked about that, how, you know, if the hunter draws really well, it's just a total stomp. We're basically seeing exactly that right now.
Yep, that's a handbook example of how you win versus handlock. Okay, so here Trump just needs to decide what to do, but as he said, Silas' Q command seems pretty damn good. 12 points of damage. Put your opponent at 1, and then if there is a Hubot, he'll be at 9, and you will have possibly 7.
There's a Hubot, you just win. You can't Hubot and tackle the board properly.
Yeah.
That's really the problem. Yep. The wide eyes of Dog.
There's no even a Hubot for Dog. No, yeah, there's no Hubot, so Dog just shows us his face.
Wow.
What do you think his face represents right now? Is it disgust? Is it disbelief?
It is.
He burns the Hubot, by the way. The final disgrace.
Yeah, but it wouldn't have been enough. Yeah, I mean, that's just what happens. This is why Hunter is never going away, because every now and then, and really not that infrequently, Hunter just pulls off a ridiculous win against any deck. And we saw just that. Not only from the Hunter, but from the Shaman as well. So Trump is our first player to advance into the HTC Recharged Final.
We kind of called it, Grip. We are this good.
We called Trump and Gaara, but Gaara has not yet secured his spot. It's going to be Gaara versus Nuguri coming right up, and they're going to be battling it off for the second spot in the final against Trump. Pretty crazy stuff, man. I think Dog probably deserved to go through a little bit more. I kind of think that the players who play like control-y decks play them really well. I think I kind of root for them in general, especially when, you know, the losses come to just ridiculous burst combos and aggression. But that's Hearthstone, man, and Trump makes it happen with the aggression.
It certainly is.
If Trump's luck continues, he's going to be unstoppable.
Well, you know, it's luck combined with the skill and with the lineup as well. So it's obviously not that he's that lucky. But as you said, like, Dog played really well, very high level play. And he brought Priest, which was, it is a surprising deck. And that game, Priest versus Malekith Warlock, the fact that he won that was actually amazing. The fatigue and everything. So we've seen a couple of really good matches, a couple of really good games, but Trump is on top. And I'm actually not only rooting for Trump personally, but I'm a big fan of this Malekith Warlock deck. I wanted to see it in the final, and I love watching it. I love the burst. I love Malekith as a card. And we are going to have more action with this.
Yep. All right, guys, stick with us. We're going to be back in 5 minutes. In the meantime, in the 5 minutes, if you guys want to do something, maybe check out our sponsor. HTC is making this happen. And if you'd like to see the promotion, they're doing $50 off their phones. And if you want to see that, you guys can check the link in the description. For now, though, we'll be about 5 minutes break while the players set up, while we get Gaara versus Nuguri set up and ready for you guys to watch. So don't go anywhere. We'll be right back.